When Carl Benz introduced his three-wheeled patent motor wagon for adults in the late 1880s, pedal cars for children appeared soon after. By the early 1900s, pedal cars were widespread, especially in the United States, England, France, and Australia. After World War II, the J40 or Junior 40, made by Lyons Brothers Triang at their Merthyr Tydfil factory in Wales, and modelled after the 1949 Austin A40, was probably the most popular pedal car in England. The cost then of £20 would be equivalent today of around £1,000, perhaps only for the wealthy. Well, today these and other pedal cars, either mass-produced or handmade, are very collectible. So let's meet one such collector.
Hello, my name is Les Stairs, and I've been collecting items of motoring memorabilia for many a year. And fortunately, I've been in the lucky position to be able to create Grandad Shed. So I'd like to welcome you to it. The very first pedal car that I purchased was back in the very early 80s when the Bewley Motor Museum started the auto jumbles. So I went along with my wife, which I'm sure she was very pleased to join me, looking at lots of auto memorabilia. Some people may call it junk, but I call it very interesting stuff, and was fortunate enough to be able to buy a very, very early Triang pedal car. I've never refurbished it, I've never really done anything to it. It's in the same condition as I bought it. When we had grandchildren a few years ago, I thought this was a golden opportunity to get back into having pedal cars. Over the years, with my friend, we've refurbished and recommissioned many classic cars, real size cars, but as we've got older, laying on the floor with a gearbox on your chest hasn't had the same appeal as it did when we were in our 20s. So moving into pedal cars has been a lot much easier and a lot more fun. I also found the infrastructure for purchasing items to refurbish the cars is very, very good. I've also noted over the time that when we refurbish these pedal cars, the enthusiasm and the friendship that I found from a lot of my colleagues in helping me do this has been absolutely superb. We've had great fun and many celebrations when we've put the things back on the road. As you can see from around the shed, I am very much a Jaguar enthusiast. You can see from the grills and the growler on the roof, and also the leaper that's in the corner. I was in a very fortunate position a few years ago to be able to purchase a one-off Jaguar XK150. This car was a special project which was undertaken under the guidance of Dr. Ertel at Rodine College. There were a number of girls that over a period of 18 months actually built this car. When I bought it, I thought, this is absolutely superb. And then I had the problem of, how was I going to get it home? This is not your normal size pedal car. It's over 6 foot long. It's got a very, very substantial metal chassis and a fiberglass body that the infrastructure is chicken wire. So you can imagine it is an incredibly heavy item. My son-in-law has a Navara truck, so we were able to put this in the back of the truck and drive it from Salisbury back to our house. It was very difficult to decide how far we should go in actually refurbishing it. I didn't want to change the car too much, but I wanted to bring it up to up to speed and to make it look as good as I think it should do, as it's a unique example of an XK150. The little pedal car is a Triang de Doyne model car. This car was originally part of a massive collection of cars owned by a cosmetic dentist. When we bought the car, we were putting it in the boot of the Jaguar that I currently owned at the time to bring it home, and my friend said, "It's not very often that the pedal car that you put in the boot of the car is actually worth more than the car that you're taking it home in." The Bugatti is another scratch-built one-off prototype car. This was made by Avro Cars. It was a man who lives in the Cotswolds, and he was unfortunately diagnosed with cancer a number of years ago. And when he recovered from the cancer, his wife said to him, "What would you really like to do?" And he said, "I don't want to go back to being an IT consultant. I'd like to make pedal cars." So he produced this car as the prototype that was going to be the basis of Avro Cars, a firm that he'd set up in the Cotswolds to make bespoke pedal cars and electric cars for people. Unfortunately, things didn't actually work out as well as he was hoping them to do, and this was the only Bugatti that he ever made. It's a conglomerate of lots of bits and pieces that he's used, as well as making a lot of the things himself. But as you can see, the grills on the side of the bonnet are from air intakes that you would find in a house. He's also used parts of spanners and wrenches to create different parts of the car. A very interesting and unique example. This maroon racing Renault pedal car is one of 500. They were produced to commemorate 100 years of Renault, and they were sent around the country to all the Renault dealers as well as in France. And when I bought the car, it wasn't put together, it was still in the box. And a number of my friends were suggesting that I should keep the car in the box. But I thought to put it in Grandad's shed in the box on the shelf wouldn't look so good. So we took it out and put it together. And as you can see, it's quite a very smart looking, well-produced one of 500 cars. This yellow and black pedal car is of very, very substantial construction and incredibly heavy. I think it would be near on impossible for one of the grandchildren to actually pedal this car around. On the top of the grill, I've got a little piece of Lalique. As I'm sure many of you will know, Lalique in the 1920s and 30s made absolutely magnificent car mascots, and this is a piece of Lalique. Unfortunately, it's not the glass version, it's the top off of one of the wife's perfume bottles. Here we have an Austin J40 replica. These were made during the latter part of the 1940s, when unfortunately a lot of people from the mines had to be rehabilitated due to many illnesses. The Austin Motor Company used all the scrap metal that they had and recycled it into making small pedal cars. It was based around one of the managing director's daughter's height. She was a 9-year-old young lady. So they used her as the model to create the Austin J40. They had a number of considerations in making the car, that it had to have an opening bonnet, it had to have an opening boot, and it had to have working headlights, just like the father's car. These cars were made in vast numbers over the years, and a lot of them were used at fairgrounds and fairground attractions. The racing of these cars also takes place every year at the Goodwood Revival meeting, where they have a special race with all the children dressed up in period clothing, racing the cars actually on the racetrack. It's absolutely superb fun. This one is a, as I say, a replica which is made of fiberglass and has an electric motor. It also has the Austin A flying badge on the bonnet, which came from India. A very interesting and very nice model to be able to own. It's in many respects the holy grail of the pedal car collections. This is a Volkswagen camper van. At a lot of the Volkswagen events, people use these to ride around in. I've seen actual men driving these things. I've tried to get in it with little success and don't intend to do it again. But the reason I've bought the camper van is that my daughter has a camper van that she hires out. Welcome to the preparation area for the pedal cars for Grandad Shed. As you can see, there's a significant number of cars awaiting preparation here. Down the bottom on this shelf here is a collection of electric motors that will eventually find their way into the Jaguar XK150 and the Austin J40 we looked at earlier. Also here is an Italian Triangle Jaguar rather than Jaguar waiting for preparation. The engine has been taken out and is getting ready to be reinstalled. The bodywork is in awful state, but with our friend who we've seen the quality of his paintwork up in the top shed, will look magnificent in time to come. We also have a Rolls-Royce here waiting for preparation, another Triang electric car. Once that's all put back together, I will have it painted the same colour as the Rolls-Royce that we owned a number of years ago. Right in front of us is a Piaggio. This is a particularly rare electric car, as it has a full braking system, two forward gears and a reverse gear. Very unusual to have brakes on a pedal car or electric car, but this one, the braking system works on all four wheels and even the red lights come on the back. I hope you enjoyed looking at some of the items that we have here. A number of them are unique and one-off, so you won't see them anywhere else, and I hope you enjoy looking at them. I've certainly enjoyed finding them and fixing them, but I don't do the other part that the programme on the television said, sell it. I just like to keep all my things, and as you can see, over the last 40-45 years, this is the result of my collection of items.